And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, December 31st, 2019. It's New Year's Eve, and in New York's Times Square, the ball is dropped at midnight, a tradition that goes back to the mid-19th century and the time signal that was given to ships at harbor when a large ball was dropped exactly at 1 p.m. every day so sailors could check their ship chronometers. The Times Square celebration goes back to 1904, when the New York Times opened its headquarters and had a big party, fireworks, on New Year's Eve. 200,000 people were there. And in 1907, the newspaper's head electrician constructed a giant lighted ball that was lowered from the building's flagpole. In Atlanta, they drop a giant peach. In Eastport, Maine, a sardine. In Ocean City, Maryland, a beach ball. In Mobile, Alabama, a 600-pound moon pie. In Tempe, Arizona, a giant tortilla chip descends into a bowl of salsa. In Brasstown, North Carolina, a plexiglass pyramid containing a live possum. And in Key West, Florida, an enormous ruby slipper with a drag queen inside it. In Scotland, New Year's Eve is the first day of Hogmanay, and if the first person to cross your threshold after midnight is a dark-haired man, you'll have good luck in the coming year. And there is drinking involved. Craig Ferguson said Hogmanay is a time when people who can inspire awe in the Irish for the amount of alcohol that they drink decide to ramp it up a notch. It's the birthday of Henri Matisse, 1869, Le Coteau, France. Had no interest in art, went to law school in Paris, never went to museums. But when he came down with a case of appendicitis and was in bed for several weeks, he took up painting to pass the time. And he said, "For the first time in my life, I felt free, quiet, and alone, carried along by a power alien to my life as a normal man." He quit the law to begin work as a full-time artist. He was a revolutionary who dressed like a bourgeois, and he once said, "It has bothered me all my life that I do not paint like everybody else." It's the birthday of the blues singer Odetta, born Odetta Holmes Phileas in Birmingham, Alabama, 1930. It's the birthday of Juno Diaz, 1968, Santo Domingo, the Dominican Republic. Grew up in New Jersey. His first novel, The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wao, won the Pulitzer Prize in 2007. Here's a poem for today by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow entitled The Meeting. After so long an absence, at last we meet again. Does the meeting give us pleasure, or does it give us pain? The tree of life has been shaken, and but few of us linger now, like the prophets, two or three berries in the top of the uttermost bough. We cordially greet each other in the old familiar tone, and we think, though we do not say it, how old and gray he is grown. We speak of a Merry Christmas and many a Happy New Year, but each in his heart is thinking of those who are not here. We speak of friends and their fortunes and of what they did and said, till the dead alone seem living and the living alone seem dead. And at last we hardly distinguish between the ghosts and the guests, and a mist and shadow of sadness steals over our merriest jests. The Meeting, a poem by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. That's the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, December 31st. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.